In this video, we will discuss a pattern that will allow you to easily determine the product of 11 and another two-digit number. And there are two cases to consider. The first case is when the sum of the digits of the two-digit number is less than 10. For the first example, we have 11 times 43, and we always focus on the factor that's not 11, in this case 43. Let's begin by summing the digits, which gives us 4 plus 3, which equals 7. And now to determine the product, we split the digits of 43 by placing the 4 on the left and the 3 on the right, and the digit in the middle is the sum of the digits, which in this case is 7. The product is 473. And again, for review, the first step was to determine the sum of the digits, which gave us the 7. The next step was to split the digits of 43 by placing the 4 on the left, or in the hundreds place value, and the 3 on the right, or in the ones place value, and the sum of the digits gave us the digit in the tens place value. For case 1, the products will always be less than or equal to 999. Next, we have 11 times 32. Let's first sum the digits of 32. 3 plus 2 is equal to 5. And now to determine the product, we split the digits of 32 by placing the 3 on the left and the 2 on the right, and the digit in the middle is the sum of the digits, which in this case is 5, giving us the product 352. Just remember, we always work with the two-digit number that is not 11. Next, we have 18 times 11. The first step is to sum the digits of 18. 1 plus 8 equals 9. Next step, split the digits of 18 by placing the 1 on the left and the 8 on the right. The digit in the middle is the sum of the digits, which is 9, giving us the product 198. And now let's take a look at case 2. For case 2, the sum of the digits of the two-digit number is greater than or equal to 10, and therefore in this case, we'll need to perform an exchange before determining the final product. For the first example, we have 11 times 87. We first sum the digits of 87. 8 plus 7 equals 15. Next step, split the digits of 87 by placing the 8 on the left, or in the hundreds place value, and the 7 on the right, or in the ones place value. And the 15 is the digit in the middle place value, or in the tens place value, but because we have 15 tens, we need to perform an exchange. 15 tens is equal to 5 tens and 1 100. So because we have a 15 in the tens place value, we place the 5 in the tens place value, perform an exchange, and place a 1 in the hundreds place value. And now to determine the final product, notice how we have 8 plus 1 or 9 in the hundreds place value, giving us a product of 957. So if the sum of the digits of the two-digit number is greater than or equal to 10, we do need to perform an exchange before determining the final product. Next, we have 55 times 11. First step, sum the digits of 55. 5 plus 5 equals 10. To determine the product, we split the digits of 55 by placing a 5 on the left and a 5 on the right. The middle digit of the digit in the tens place value is 10, and therefore we need to perform an exchange. 10 tens is equal to 1 100, so we place a 0 in the tens place value and a 1 in the hundreds place value. Notice now we have 5 plus 1 or 6 in the hundreds place value. The product is 605. And for the last example, we have 11 times 76. First step, sum the digits of 76. 7 plus 6 equals 13. To determine the product, we split the digits of 76 by placing the 7 on the left, the 6 on the right, and the middle digit, with a digit in the tens place value, is 13. Because this is greater than or equal to 10, we need to perform an exchange. 13 tens gives us a 3 in the tens place value and a 1 in the hundreds place value, and therefore the final product is 836, because we have 1 plus 7, or an 8, in the hundreds place value. I hope you found this interesting.